Welcome back. My name is Danielle Dupuis, and right now we're just going to take a look at the men's basketball game. We got a big game coming up for the guys right now against the Niagara Knights. So right now the boys are standing at 9-2 for games. Now, if the boys win this tonight, that puts them in a playoff spot. So it's very tough teams tonight. They're going to be looking for that win. So thank you very much, and I'm going to be passing it back up to Danielle and Connor. Thank you.
Don Tremont, I'm sitting here with Connor Forrest, and we're here at what could be the most important game of the OCAA regular season. Like Danielle said, the standings are quite tight. Humber is second in the Western Conference and third coming in at the Knights. Now we have three seniors here tonight that are going to be leaving after this year, so their last game at home. We have Edifel, Dixon, and Martin. We're all in their fifth year, their last home game tonight.
Absolutely. So it's an emotional night for these guys. It's the last time they'll be playing in this gym, and what a matchup. What a way to send it up.
Yeah.
The second and third ranked team in OCAA matchup to be. Nobody wants to play Sheridan, that's for sure. So we could definitely see these two teams playing down the line. Niagara struck first, winning their first matchup. Humber blew a fourth quarter lead. They're looking to win it back, and history is in their favor. 33-10. Humber is all-time against the Knights in this gym. Key player, Tyrone Dixon. He's the Humber's all-time leading rebounder, and he's going to be a big factor in this game. Humber is number one in rebounds margin per game, so he's really going to step it up. Niagara, second in the league in scoring. Meanwhile, Humber, the first-ranked team in points allowed. So this is going to be a phenomenal matchup, Danielle.
Holy, look at those stats there. Dixon is essential to this team, and we have to remember that these three players that are leaving after this year, they were quintessential in getting this team to the CCAA's 2014-2015 season after a 14-year drought.
Gibson Edifel will be the second one as well. He's the third ranked in the CCAA for assists. And we now just have an announcement made by Humber executives.
Thank you for joining us this evening. Certainly over the years, your support has meant a lot to their pursuit.
But a huge game coming up right here, guys.
Tonight we're honoring two exceptional athletes, two individuals that stood out, leading our college to a national championship 2 years ago. I'd like to begin by acknowledging Ansel Martin. Ansel has been a tremendously versatile player over his years with Humber College. Won an OCAA championship twice. He was a CCAA All-Star. And certainly a big part of our national championship team. Today we're also acknowledging our all-time leader in rebounding and blocks, a former athlete of the year, just an absolute tremendous basketball player, leader, one of the great individuals to come to our basketball program. Tyrone Dixon. Thank you.
wonderful to see those two senior players being honored here tonight. Just like we mentioned, essential to getting them to the CCAAs 2014-2015.
Absolutely. Ansel Martin, 13 points per game, is a 40% shooter. Scarborough, Ontario, congratulations to him. And Tyrone Dixon, as mentioned, a leader, all-time rebounds and blocks. He's going to be critical tonight. And the third player that we didn't get to mention, Gibson Edible, the CCAA third rank in assists. He is going to be crucial as well, averaging a good amount of points, just below a double-double himself. He is going to be one of the key factors to Humber coming out on top. They are the fourth-ranked team in rebounds and one of the best assisting teams as well, with about 16.8 to round out the year. It's going to be quite a matchup.
Definitely, but I mean, the Niagara Knights are also something to be reckoned with. Who are we going to talk about now? I think you know, Laquan.
In their last matchup, Laquan put up big numbers, roughly about 22 points in that last matchup. He really did the Humber Hawks in, especially in that fourth quarter. The Humber Hawks put up a season-low 8 points in the fourth quarter, where Laquan actually shined, putting up the bulk of his points. So the Humber Hawks for this game, they got to finish the race. It's a marathon, not a sprint, all the way to the end. Got to look at Laquan. We also got to look at Van Hutchison Jr., 14 points a game. It's going to be very interesting to see how those two play out. Humber being an exceptionally well-defensive team, as I mentioned before, number one in points allowed with 67 a game. It's phenomenal. Ooh.
Okay, so you're sitting there, you're on the bench. What are you giving as advice to the Humber Hawks right now? What are they going to need to pull through in this game against the Knights?
We recently just saw the women's team absolutely dominate the Knights on the boards in their own respect. I'm actually going to say that's going to be critical to the Humber Hawks notching out a win in this one. The Niagara Knights are a phenomenally powerful and potent scoring team. Like I said, they're second in the league. They put up almost 90 a night. So they're really going to need to dominate the boards, get second chance opportunities, and D up. But the Humber Hawks, a phenomenal defensive team. So I have no worries about them in that respect.
Definitely. Speaking about the scoring coming from the Niagara players, they have Van Hutchison Jr. coming from the Bahamas, averages 14.6 points per game, 21st in the OCAA.
Absolutely.
Right now.
He's another potent addition to this team, which is partly why they are second in points per game. They're second in field goals made. They're third in field goals attempted per game. So they're definitely going to put up a lot of shots, and that's where the defense is going to come in, and we are ready to go.
Definitely. Coming in for the Hawks, strong, fighting for that ball down in the key, up, and it's a miss. Going down, fighting for that ball outside the key. We got number 33 putting it up, and that's going to be a basket.
Jordan McDonald.
For the Knights, that's for McDonald there, outside the key. We've got Ansel Martin passing out. He's passing out to Gibson Edifol to Bennett. Bennett up for three and just misses.
And I love CJ Bennett's game. He likes to hang out on the left wing, but he's great when it comes to running the fast break and driving it inside. Look out for CJ Bennett in this game.
Absolutely amazing. McCuna coming up, passing out to Saboni. Saboni passes in, driving it in, trying to get it in that key. Once again, Jordan McDonald trying to get it in there. The current score is 0-2 for the Knights.
And much like the women's team, this Humber team is very deep. If it's not Ansel Martin, it's CJ Bennett. They can bring Trayvon Mollison off the bench. They have a number of great additions to this team, both young and senior.
Definitely, we're passing in. Oh, and gets intercepted coming in from Helton. Driving it in the top of the key, shoots, and he scores.
Now, we talked about this team being very, very strong offensively, and they are second in the league in field goals made and third in field goals attempted. They're going to put up shots. You need to get stops.
Edifol passing around, comes out to Judge. Judge goes up for three and misses. The ball's going back to the Knights. McDonald passing it in to Van Hutchinson, that star we were talking about earlier. Helton taking the ball up. Small but mighty, driving it up the court.
Laquan put up 22 the last time they met.
Van Hutchinson driving in the key and up on that rebound. Rebounds with one hand and drives it in.
Getting his own rebound, the Hawks. Let's see what they can do. The Hawks are exceptional in the half court. Just a little bit of a slow start.
Edifol driving it out, passing it to Judge. Judge back to Edifol. Edifol with some ball work there. Out to Judge. Shoots for three. Just misses off the rim. And that's a rebound from McDonald. McDonald passing to Van Hutchinson, who drives it back up the court. Van Hutchinson passes it out to Makuna. Makuna for three, just off that rim there, misses it. And we're coming back to Judge. Judge passes it up to Edifel. Edifel drives into the key, passes it out to beautiful Bennett, who was open there.
Now Judge is a 26% three-point shooter, and he's over two so far. Not the start we wanted, and he loves to hang out on the baseline there. So if he can get going, they can really open up the floor. And CJ Bennett, back door, second year.
Beautiful. Coming back in for the Knights. Ben Hutchinson Jr. brings it up to the top. A little bit of ball work there through the legs. Taking his time, driving it into the key, passing to Saboni, who just misses, was underneath that glass there.
Ooh, hustle play there, and Judge getting the sour end of it. And it's gonna be Niagara ball, both teams hustling early.
Edifel getting a bit frustrated there, passing in Helton. It's anyone's game here in the Hawks Nest. It's 3-6 for the Knights. Passing it back in for the Knights, we got Makuna. And it's out. And it's gonna be a Humber ball. Edifel taking it back in. You can tell these boys are already getting worked up in this game.
Jordan McDonald, Tyrone Dixon, a good matchup there. Dixon with the height.
Martin passing the ball out. Back out to Edifel. Edifel passing it into Martin and right underneath the net, just misses it off the backboard. Back to Jordan McDonald, bringing it up. Passes it out to Halton. Halton doing a bit of ball work there. Passing it into the bottom of the key. And that's up for Saboni and just misses it.
Good defense there. And here's the fast break that Humber loves to run. They're coming down.
Edifel just off that backboard. Just a bit too quick there, wouldn't you say?
A bit too strong off the glass. I think he was hoping for Martin to get the rebound, but it's going to come down with two hands.
And it's Edifel's ball again. Oh, no, sorry. He thought it was his ball, but it's Saboni's ball taking it back for the Knights. Ooh, we got a full court press going on right now.
Oh, quick steal. Oh, my God. And CJ Bennett blowing the easy layup. But Bennett already with a few opportunities, and he's a second year. I really like him.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Number 14, Makuna driving it up. Passes to Saboni in the paint, just misses it. And we've got McDonald just missing that as well. Going in two, missing it was Judge for the Hawks. Coming back up, and Hutchinson, star player, driving it back up the court to the top of that three-point arc. Passing it out to Halton. Taking it in, they got 10 seconds on the clock. Halton drives it into the key and just misses it. But we got a breakaway coming from Edifel, who drives it down the court and misses off the backboard. Again, Saboni throws it back in. Dixon drives it.
A tough shot, no call there. Gonna be going in the favor of Niagara is number four, Payam Saboni, but 2 points for the Hawks, down 2-3.
Whew, anyone's game at this point. Edifel trying to drive it back in. Back out to Judge. Judge passes it in, and that's another point for Dixon.
Back-to-back buckets for Dixon. And one thing that I really like between him and Edifel is the high screen and roll that they love to run. You'll see it a lot throughout this game when they bust it out. Those two are very lethal at the top of the key.
Coming back out to Halton. A little bit of ball work there. Coming back in to Star McDonald, and back out, intercepted by Judge. Judge throws it back to Edifel to slow it down a bit, but Edifel is just driving it into the paint. Drives it out, passes to Ansel Martin. Woo, nothing but net on that one.
And I love Dixon fighting for the rebounds. As we mentioned before, this Niagara team, they are number one in rebounds, defensive and total, second in offensive rebounds. So they are really going to have to fight down low.
You can tell these boys are fighting. We just saw Dixon down on the ground there. They are not going to let this one go easy. It's a one-point game here, Connor. What do you think?
And if you're Niagara, what you really want to do is get Dixon into foul trouble. He's had problems with fouls in past. So far this season, he's been good. But right now, he has just picked up his first. And then we see Trayvon Mollison coming in. Him and Kerwin Elvis. I love those two guys off the bench. They bring a lot.
We got Hutchinson with the ball. Olé! Takes a shot from all the way downtown from the CN Tower, but he misses it. Driving it outside, and we've got a drive coming in from Bennett.
And you look at the youth, Danielle, on this team, where you have C.J. Bennett, you have Kerwin Elvis, you have Trayvon Mollison, and you have Jordan Rose. All of these guys, second, third-year players, and I really think they're the future of this team.
Definitely Jordan Rose passing it in there, coming back out to Mollison. Mollison passing out to Rose. Driving it in, just off that backboard. Just a little bit of fumbling here.
Absolutely. Hands in the passing lane. Balls go out of bounds all the time, but some great ball movement from the Hawks earlier. They got a lead with consecutive stops.
Passing it back in. We got Mollison with the ball. 3 seconds on the shot clock, and he goes. Mollison tries to beat that clock, but he gets a travel violation.
Tough shot there. Some great defense from the Knights, as expected. Easy shots will not come. Fighting for him.
Someone's telling me they're going to be fighting that shot clock all night. Both teams relentless on the defense and the offense. Bringing it back up. We got Van Hutchinson Jr. Now with the ball. Ekendell brings it back in. And Humber's ball once again. Bringing it in. Judge bringing it back in. Refocusing the team. Back to Rose at the top. Down to the corner we have Bennett. Driving it back in, we have Rose passing it out to Judge and Mollison for three, but just misses. But a rebound coming in from CJ Bennett. Back out to the top. Jordan Rose, 7 seconds on that shot clock. Bringing it back in, we have Dixon driving in and just missing. But a rebound coming from Van Hutchinson Jr. Bringing it back up for the Niagara Knights.
Offensive rebound, didn't quite make any second chance points there, but it's good that these Humber Hawks are fighting on the boards.
Almost a dunk there coming in from Acuna off of Hutchinson's rebound. 3-point shot going to Ekendale. 6'2" guard from Welland, Ontario. Driving it back up, number 24. Mollison passing it back to Rose. Rose passing it out to Bennett. Bennett to Rose. Back into Judge. Back out to CJ Bennett. Back out to a 3-point miss for Jordan Rose. And back in for Dixon. I can barely call that. So many passes going on here.
Absolutely. Another offensive rebound for Tyrone Dixon. And this time, second chance. Boy, it's a tough call there on the reach and foul. We saw that last play. Dixon fighting ferociously for those boards. That's what he's got to do against such a potent rebounding team like Niagara. And if he can do that and create second chance points, I really like Humber's chances. And for some reason in this building, the Hawks have just been able to get it done. They're actually searching their 17th consecutive win against Niagara in this building. So something about the Hawks' nest seems to get to the Knights, but might not be this time. 11 all.
Yeah, hoping we can hatch a win here in the Hawks' nest this evening. Edifel definitely performing tonight, but I think he's a bit more powerful on the assist tonight. A lot of passing coming from Edifel at the key moments. Finding out who's open for that 3-point shot.
Absolutely. We just saw CJ Nifuente play, and she's a floor general slash scorer.
Definitely.
CJ plays both, but Gibson Edifel is your definition of a point guard, a floor general. He orchestrates the offense. That's right. He's ranked third in assists in the country. And is one of the first Humber athletes in this program to reach the milestone of 300 career assists. So Edifel.
Definitely. Edifel is averaging 5 assists per game going into this match. And he did break that record against Redeemer. He is something to watch out for. It's not just his offensive charging, because you see how hard he's hustling to get it past half as these boys are pressing him on the Knights, but also the fact that he knows exactly where to pass it to at the exact right time.
He's got great floor vision. CJ Bennett and Tyrone Dixon with the bulk of the scoring so far. That's what we expected.
Definitely Dixon is averaging 11.4 rebounds per game. With just height alone, he's 6'5". Holy.
As we discussed earlier, marquee OCAA matchup here. The loser of this, in all likelihood, will have to play a crossover match, denying themselves a bye into the tournament itself. So they will have to go up against an eighth-ranked team, something both of these teams would like to avoid. Being able to get that rest is crucial to the later stages of the tournament.
Definitely. Akindele passing it in. It's a fumble off of Niagara, passing it back out for Humber's ball. We have a substitution coming in.
And Judge, he's had a rough few minutes so far. He's 0-for-3 from the field. Still a great defender, but Ansel Martin, I like this, getting a lot of height down low. But Dixon, not in the game. It'll be interesting to see how the Hawks perform rebounding-wise.
Really good to see Martin back in the game. Jordan Rose trying to drive it in there, passing it back out. Not looking to Ansel Martin, who is free at the top of the arc. 4 seconds left on the shot clock. Traveling violation, that was.
Second traveling call in the last few plays we've seen against Humber. So both these guys a little antsy.
Definitely. It's a tight game. Tie game, 11-11. Here in the Hawks' nest. 21 from the Knights driving in. That is Morrison. Fighting for that ball. Passing it back out to his teammate, Van Hutchinson, with the ball. Driving it in. Beautiful layup by Hutchinson.
Clear cut to the basket. Strong left-hand drive. He's tough to stop once he breaks the defense.
Passing it back out. They love passing around the arc this game. Jordan Rose passing it out. And, misses for three. That was Mollison.
Knights, what a find by the Knights, number 21. That was TJ Morrison. What a pass there, off balance, finding his teammate. Play didn't go in their favor, but still, what a play.
Still, the effort is showing and the energy in this place. I mean, it's packed in the Hawks' nest tonight. You can feel the energy.
Absolutely. Last home game for the Hawks this season. Not to mention that both of these teams are riding an 8-game winning streak.
Rose to Elvis. Elvis back in to Martin, who misses that shot. Rebound from Elvis back in. Martin taking the ball, passing it back out to Elvis, back into Ajulu. Ajulu out to the corner, and Rose.
And he'll draw the foul on that.
Oh! Beautiful. Jordan Rose, guard, coming in at third year from Toronto, Ontario.
And he's one of the guys I love coming off the bench. Jordan Rose, Mollison, Elvis, these guys make plays, not just for their teammates, but they can make plays for themselves. And here we go, the pump fake.
Beautiful replay.
Contact
there
on the shot.
For one, and he makes that shot. Okay, coming back up. You've got Van Hutchinson Jr. bringing it back up for his team. DJ Morrison passing it out. Passing it out to Wilson, who passes it to DJ Morrison, who gets the shot, but unfortunately does not count.
Now, one thing that this Humber team has really going for them is that the Knights do not like to shoot three-pointers. They are 11th in the league in three-pointers attempt. They love to go down low and bang on the boards. And with Tyrone Dixon and other players like Ajulu in there, this is a really good situation for them.
You're definitely right about that, Connor. Passing it back out at the top of the arc and driving in there. Elvis. These boys are hungry for that point.
Kerwin Elvis going for the hack on the arm. And best situation, you get one of the Niagara players into foul trouble. And both teams with three team fouls. Laquan going to check back in. He's been a little bit quiet in the first 10 minutes of this game.
See what he can bring in now. The current score is 14-13 for the Humber Hawks. Passing it back out to Julu. Oh, and a breakaway by Van Hutchinson, driving it in the key. Over and oh, beautiful rebound from McDonald there. Getting that point. Elvis bringing it back up the court. Passes off to Rose. Rose, the top of the arc, calling it. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. 6 seconds left. Bringing in Mollison, driving it in. Oh, and Van Hutchinson for the Hail Mary. And he misses it, but it was a beautiful attempt.
It's going to be a travel call.
1.4 seconds left.
1.4 seconds, and the Hawks actually are going to have another opportunity to possibly take the lead. Strange call there on the last second shot.
Rose passing it back in. What are they going to play? Shooting it up. Oh, just misses it. That was Ansel Martin trying to get that 1.4 second shot. The current score is 14-15 for the Niagara Knights. Whew.
And a good showing for both teams, even though the score relatively low and this Niagara team being a very high-powered offense. I like the type of shots that they're taking. Hustle plays, shots down low. I really think this game is going to come down to the fourth quarter because both these teams are so deep, so well-conditioned. It's going to really be interesting to see how they play in the fourth quarter. We know the last time they met, Humber really got outdone in the fourth quarter. Laquan Hilton put up a lot of points. They only scored 8 in total, so watch out for that fourth quarter. Right now, both teams playing a very well-paced basketball game.
Well, definitely. And, I mean, we've looked a lot at Bennett, Edipole, Martin, Dixon. But let's talk about the Knights for a second. Van Hutchinson Jr. coming in from the Bahamas, 6'4", 8.8 rebounds per game average, and he plays an average of 29.5 minutes per game, so they don't want to get him off the court.
Absolutely not. He's a great player. He puts up rebounds and he puts up numbers. He can play defense, and when you have that size, when you have that threat in the paint, it changes the dynamic of the game, especially when Humber, a team that likes to go inside, is your opponent. This is a really good guy to have on the floor, and you saw him make a number of plays there. The steal on Ajulu, and of course McDonald with the rebound. Just looking at a few stats right here in terms of turnovers, Humber with 6. Meanwhile, the Knights with 4. As for the rebounding game, both teams, 13 rebounds for the Knights, 12 rebounds in total for the Humber Hawks. So these two teams are neck and neck. Very interesting game we have here, and this is likely going to be one of your semifinal games in the OCAA tournament coming up March 2nd.
Definitely. We speak about rebounds there for a second. The Hawks have out-rebounded their opponents by a margin of 11.7 rebounds per game on average, but I don't think it's going to be that far away this game. I think it's going to be pretty tight on the rebounds. They're both sticking by that net and making sure they grab any ball that's free.
Absolutely. The Humber Hawks are number one in rebound margin, but these Knights are second in the league in rebound margins per game behind the Humber Hawks, and they are first overall in total rebounds.
Holy, anyone's game. That was Molson up for 3 and just misses that off the rim, but fighting for that ball, passes back to Rose. Rose back at the top of the arc. Rose passes to Edipole. Edipole back to Rose. Rose back to Martin. Martin passing back to Molson and driving in, but losing that ball. And Hutchinson Jr. clapping about that, excited to have the ball back for the Knights. Excited to get a few more points here. Knights coming up the court with number 14, Makuna. Makuna driving it up to the top of the three-point arc. Back to Hilton.
And they're going to look to Hilton to make a few plays. High screen and roll.
Hilton driving it into the key. Just missing. Driving it back. Edipole bringing it in all the way for that beautiful layup. No foul there. But we do drive it in with Ansel Martin down in the paint.
Absolutely, and Edipole going strong to the rim. He doesn't get the bucket, but he knows his teammates are there collapsing. But Niagara answering right back. McDonald.
Beautiful. McDonald just driving it in there, making it look easy standing at 6'3". And now we have Edipole top of the arc. Edipole to Rose. Rose out to Mollison. Mollison out to Edipole. Trying to pass it in there to Rose and just misses that shot. Rebounded by McDonald. Bringing back up by Hilton. Driving that ball forward for the Knights, but fumbling, and that's going to be a foul.
The Humber Hawks 0 of 6 from downtown in that first quarter. Meanwhile, the Knights 1 of 3. And that's not Niagara's game in terms of 3 points attempted. So it'll be interesting to see if they take more threes down the line, considering that they are shooting significantly better than the Hawks.
Definitely. Hilton passing into Saboni there, missing that three. Coming back out to Bennett. Bennett passing out to Edipole. And 4-3, Daquan Cascard, who just came out off the bench. Coming out fresh, coming out strong.
And he nails the first three for the Hawks, and they now have a one possession game lead.
Makuna passing out to Hilton. Hilton passing out to Saboni. Saboni passing it out to Makuna down in that bottom post. Shoot going up. Beautiful shot from Makuna. Almost blocked on that one, but he made it through. Edifel passing it out to Martin. Back to Edifel. Passing it back out to Kaskar. Passing it to Edifel for three. Oh, beautiful. Nothing but net on that one.
Edifel with his first bucket of the game. A threat from outside is Humber team.
Makuna driving it up to the top of the arc. Hilton wide open, but he's going to drive it in to the paint. Push it up there. Just misses that shot. Beautiful rebound from Dixon, just standing underneath that 6 foot six, just right underneath that net.
0 of 6 for threes in the first, but 2 of 2 in the second. Oh. And they're moving it around nicely.
Bringing that ruckus. Oh, in and out from Martin, who just misses that shot. Oh, wow, beautiful shot. Pass from Dixon all the way back to half court from his back. Fighting the shot clock here. Wow. Dixon making that pass, lying down. That was just beautiful.
Absolutely. And here we got that replay from Descartier. And there we go. Coming off the bench. Oh, excuse me. That's Edifel. That's his first three. Prior to that, Daquan Carstay making his first three. But Ansel Martin struggling from the field right now. He's shooting 1-for-5, 20%. Those mid-range 12-foot jumpers not quite falling right now. But a timeout called. And we'll have ourselves a minute.
Holy, I mean, I'm just looking at the heights alone on these teams. I mean, Ansel Martin standing at 6'5", Dixon standing at 6'6". I mean, some of the rebounds, I don't even think these men are jumping for the rebounds. They're just kind of standing there and grabbing the ball. I think the rebounds are going to be pretty essential to this next few minutes of the game. What do you think?
Absolutely. Rebounding is going to be critical. Ball movement as well. I mean, when dealing with two teams of this caliber, second and third ranked teams in their respective divisions, I mean, anything goes. And they're so exceptional in basically every aspect of their game. I mean, when you look at the Humber Hawks, 18 assists per game. They're one of the best rebounding teams. When you look at the Niagara Knights, they are the second best rebounding team in the league, first in some respective categories. So they just match up so well with each other. One is one of the best defensive teams. The other is one of the best offensive teams. So quite the matchup here, and that explains why both these guys are chasing Sheridan, the number one ranked team in the country.
Oh, definitely. I mean, it's 3-point deficit right now. Hawks at 22, Knights at 19. Honestly, it's anyone's game at this point. Hilton bringing it back up, taking his time for the Knights. Getting met by Edifel right there at half. Being driven. Saboni trying to block him. Doesn't work out. Bennett trying to get a block. And it's going out to Saboni. And he shoots and he scores for 3 points.
Ooh, and Edifel getting a little bit too ahead of himself there. The outlet pass to Dixon, a little bit too strong.
Trying to rush there, got it off the referee's foot. They're going to have to slow it down a little bit. Hilton taking it back up, slowing it down to half. But he's aggressive. He's going to start charging. Maybe down into the key, looking out to Saboni. Saboni at three. Taking the ball, charging it in, passing it out to Wilson. Wilson driving it in and just missing that shot. Dixon with the rebound, bringing it back up to Edifel. Edifel driving in, slowing down at the arc. Edifel into Kaylee. Kaylee out the top of the arc, passing it in to Wilson. Wilson drives it in and gets a point.
CJ Bennett there, that's why I love his game. Baseline, right-handed drive, and he takes his defender one-on-one. He's the kind of guy who loves to make his own shots.
Beautiful play there. Going down. Hilton for three. Oh, did it even touch the rim?
Oh, that was nothing but net. 22 Woo. Points a game the last time they met. And the starting guard knocks down his first triple, tying it up.
Kaskar Edifel driving it in now, just missing that shot, though. We have Wilson bringing it back up, passing it out to Van Hustensen Jr., driving it back in. And driving it in. Oh, Saboni driving it up. Getting fouled and going to the free throw line.
And Saboni has been very active. I'm liking what I'm seeing for him. He's great on the low block. He's getting fouls. He's getting touches. He's great off the dribble.
Definitely.
Another offensive weapon for this Knights team explains why they are second in points per game with 90 a game.
Saboni also in his fifth year. The Knights are going to be losing him this year. He's a forward from from London, Ontario. And as you can see, he's 6'3". Definitely a force to be reckoned with. They're definitely going to miss him next year on the team. Just missing that shot. And back out. We've got back with the ball. Van Hutchinson Jr. driving it all the way in. Almost blocked by Martin, but he makes it for 2 points.
And great hang time there. Going up with the left hand, waiting for his defender to fall. Meanwhile, he stays up nice and high. And easy bucket there for him.
Edifel bringing up the court. Looking out. Bennett moving across, making room for Edifel. Edifel passing it in, trying to get it in that key, but not working with his pass to Judge. But a fumbling there. Hilton trying to pass it up to Saboni. Saboni bringing it into the key and passing it off. Oh!
Block from behind. And no call. That's clean as a whistle there. Great defense there from the Humber Hawks.
Beautiful. Hilton passing it back in. Hilton to Van Hutchinson Jr., who was able to align up for that three. Missed it. And
soaring high and getting one of his second bucket to go. There we go, and the outlet pass there. The fast break game, they don't wait. They go straight to the rack, getting the crowd involved. And it's a neck and neck game, 26-27. A big play there from Martin.
Holy, he almost broke the backboard on that one. These boys are fighting for this, driving it in. Van Hutchinson. Bring it back up, Edifel. Hustling that ball up that court, not wasting any time as point guard. Ansel Martin pushing around a little bit. A foul, not even having the ball. Martin's getting a bit fired up, as you can tell.
Absolutely, not to mention head coach Keith Vassell. Keith Vassell, third year head coach. He wasn't happy with that call either.
No, definitely not. He's been standing up most of this game. I don't think he sat down once. It's a pretty high anxiety game, but these coaches are not going to let it go to anyone easily. Right now it's a 3-point deficit. Hawks at 26 and the Knights at 29 points. Saboni passing it back in for the Knights to Hilton.
And Ajulu's going to come back in, get some size down low. And Dixon will take a break. Conditioning, so crucial, especially when you have two teams that can go as deep as they do.
Hutchinson trying to drive it in. Humber is fighting for this ball, though. Bennett down on the ground, fighting for it alongside his teammate, number 20.
And expect to see Hutchinson take a break sooner or later. As we mentioned before, playing an incredible amount of minutes, 27. Plus minutes a game for this guy. Right now, he has logged 10 minutes, and that is after the first quarter, not even counting the second.
Definitely him and Wilson and Cooper all coming from Nassau in the Bahamas. Pretty talented basketball players out there in the Bahamas, I guess. Really killing it for this team right now. A threat to Humber's victory. Bringing it back out. We have Edifel at the top, driving back in, passing it out to Bennett. Bennett was open but fumbles the ball. Hilton drives it in.
Ooh.
Deeks out for a beautiful layup.
Laquan Hilton with the Euro. We got some Niagara fans in the stands.
Holy.
And now a 5-point lead for the Knights. Timeout called by the Humber.
Okay. Wow. It's a 5-point game, but I'm telling you, it's anyone's game at this point. Would you say, Connor?
Oh, absolutely. In a game of this level, it goes back and forth. Consecutive plays. It was a 1-point game. Two easy buckets and one being a fast break off of the turnover. It's now a 5-point game. Head coach Patrick Oliver, the Humber Hawks, in his second year, enjoying the longest win streak of his coaching career as a head coach with 8 consecutive wins. He'll draw something up, and they'll get a bucket coming right back. It'll be interesting to see how the game progresses. Got lots of time left in this second, so we will see how both teams respond.
Definitely, and I think it says something about the Hawks, how much rotation we're seeing in this lineup right now. I mean, they're not just composed of their best players. they are rotating in and out and in and out because they have six men, seven men, eight men. The entire bench is just absolutely stacked for the Hawks.
Absolutely, and the same can be said about Niagara. It's not Hutchison, it's DJ Morrison, and you can go off to Hutchison. So a lot of different elements to both of these teams here, and they know that it's a marathon, not a sprint.
Definitely. Hilton bringing it back up. Speaking of someone who's had a lot of play time, him and Hilton. Hilton now driving it in, passing it back out to Saboni. Oh, and completely blocked by Judge. Bringing it back up. We've got Ansel Martin. Bringing it back in and back at the top. Judge shoots and misses. Bringing it, driving it back in. Ansel Martin, but missing. And Bennett goes up for the shot, misses almost an and one, but he misses for, so he's shooting for two at the free throw line.
Tough shot, though. He was leaning back almost outside the key itself, and he still manages to almost get that one to go. Judge missing another shot. He's still struggling from downtown. He's yet to make one. Let's see if he can get going here in the last 3 minutes here, and substitutions coming in for the Knights.
Saboni taking a much deserved break here, getting off that court.
Averaging about 8 points a game on better than 20 minutes.
And he makes that shot, bringing it back out to Van Hutchinson Jr. is going to bring it back up that court. Met with the press with Ansel Martin just waiting for him at half. Coming back out, we have Morrison driving it out, passing to Hilton, and Hilton gets the three with nothing but net. Olé.
Juan Hilton making it happen. Three ball, nothing but net. Oh, but point guard versus point guard. No.
Oh, Edible almost. Oh, shooting it off that court. Takes a moment to plant himself. And holy, McDonald just getting that in makes it look easy.
The Knights are rolling with it right now, and they need to stop. The double teams are coming out. They are feeling it.
Definitely.
Let's see if the Hawks can respond.
CJ Bennett to Edible. Edible driving it in, looking to Martin. No, looks to Edible instead, to Bennett. Bennett for three.
CJ Bennett making it happen again. Back-to-back plays where Bennett has been getting it done.
Number 21 for the Knights, DJ Morrison. A little bit of ball play there. Taking outside. Oh, beautiful behind-the-back pass. And a beautiful, clear shot for Van Hutchinson Jr.
They started off the quarter 1 of 3 from downtown and have since gone on to make three.
Ooh, and they're not even on the line there. They're way past downtown on some of these shots. Beautiful shots coming out from both teams. Edible at the top, passing back out to Ansel Martin. Passing back into Zulu and back out to Bennett. Bennett missing that shot, but Edible right back on there, passing it in. Coming back out to Judge, taking some time. 8 seconds left on the clock. Edible sitting at the top of the arc, passing out to Judge, and he shoots. Oh, just misses for three. Edible bringing it back in for the layup, misses down on the ground, back in to Zulu, who shoots and misses.
And a tough break there.
Up to Hilton, who shoots and scores. What? I need to catch my breath after that play.
Juan Hilton, heat check right there. He is feeling it, and a tough break for Humber, who just couldn't get it to go on the offensive rebound. Mm-hmm. They're looking at Bennett to make a play. And Hilton on a reach in there is going to take a sloppy foul. But Hilton, nothing but smiles right now. 15 points on 3 3 balls.
Hilton, how can he not be excited with that kind of play? I mean, just back and forth, that steal. Beautiful shots coming up from Hilton tonight.
He dropped 22 in their last encounter, sealing that fourth quarter, and he's doing it again.
Passing back into Zulu, misses it, but getting pressed here by Bennett. Bennett's not letting it get away, but that will be a foul, unfortunately. Chasing that ball just a little bit too hard now, maybe feeling that 12-point deficit a little bit too much, getting a bit nervous.
Definitely, they need a stop, and they need a big break on one of these offensive possessions. Even if Niagara doesn't score, they're using the clock, they're controlling the pace of the game.
Hilton, 5'10" guard from Mississauga, passing it back out to Morrison with a little bit of ball play there, and that's going to be foul.
It's going to be an offensive foul, shoulder. And Laquan not happy with that, that's for sure.
substitution we have. Akindele coming back in.
Him and Van Hutchinson Jr. More than half of their team's points combining for 26 right now.
Edifel taking some time, taking it slow, refocusing this game. Still anyone's game. 12 seconds on the clock. And guarded closely by Hilton, trying to push it up a bit. Judge getting open. Judge passing out to Cascart. Back to Judge. Back to Edifel for 3 points. There we go.
And a great way to close out the half. Edifel getting a three of his own. He was a little bit cold in the opening quarters, but it's become a battle of the guards right here. Laquan Hilton versus Gibson Edifel. We got a replay coming up after this, but a 9-point deficit to overcome here in the second half. And there you see it, Edifel closing out with the fire.
Beautiful shots taken here. Gonna have to tighten up that offense a little bit, but it's still anyone's game at 9 points. The Knights at 42 and the Hawks at 33. And we'll be back right after this break to find out who's gonna win the most important game of the OCAA regular season. Right after this. And we're back in the Hawks' nest for this highly contested game. Right now, the Knights at 42, the Hawks at 33, and what an all-star lineup we have on both teams. But I want to talk for a second about Tyrone Dixon, number 10 coming in at 6'5", Humber's all-time leading rebounder. He averaged going to this game 11.4 rebounds per game, the third best average in the CCAA. 32 double-doubles to his name. Holy, what are you thinking about Dixon in this game?
Absolutely. In this game, he's been fantastic when he's been on the court. He's 3-4 from the field. He's nearly got 10 rebounds, 8 total so far. But he's only had 13 minutes in that first half. And I think Patrick Oh really seeing that score is going to really put Tyrone Dixon in for a lot of these minutes in the second half. The big problem for Hunter is Laquan Hilton. 6 of 9 from the field, 3 of 4 from downtown. And that's interesting because this Niagara team, traditionally they don't shoot a lot of three-pointers. They're 11th in the league in three-pointers attempt, and they're 30% as a team from downtown. But this guy just taking over, and he put 9 points up on the board just like that. And the Humber Hawks find themselves down 9 points because of Laquan Hilton. 15 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists. A great stat line for the young man so far. So the Hawks really need to work on that perimeter defense. We mentioned this early on. They average about 60 points. They keep their opponents too. But right now, the Knights on pace for about 80. So we talk about the offense versus defense. Right now, the offense is getting the better of the defense.
Definitely. Thanks for that insight, Connor. We have Edifol coming back in, driving it outside, bringing back into Ansel Martin for 3. Oh, beautiful. Nothing but net on that 3.
That's a great thing to see. Martin was 3 of 8, and he makes his first 3-ball. That's a great way to start off the second half.
Definitely. Hutchinson passing out to Hilton, that threat we were talking about earlier, and him just driving it in, and nothing but net on that one. Just tips it in. Okay, we got Edifol coming back up this court, going alongside Bennett, passing it out to Judge, passing it back to Edifol, passing it back out to Bennett. Still on that arc. fighting that clock now. 10 seconds left. Putting it up with Dixon. And he rebounds his own shot and puts it back up for the foul.
And that is going to be the reason why the Humber Hawks can win this game. Tyrone Dixon gets his own rebound and puts it right back in. There you see Ansel Martin, who has been quiet, only 6 points up until this point, drops a three ball in the opening 30 seconds of the half. And Dixon now looking for a three-point play of his own.
Dixon definitely going to be missed. He's in the fifth year at Humber. Makes that shot like it's no problem at all.
Dixon, a 70% free throw shooter. Fairly good for a big man.
Coming back up, Van Hutchinson Jr. driving it back up. Slowing it down a little bit. Saboni making that block for him and getting open in the key. Doesn't see him though, so he drives it out. Passes it back out to Makuna, who drives it into the key. Deeks and gets it in. Holy, these boys are working that ball right now.
Absolutely. We talk about the big three. We've talked a lot about Hutchinson, and we've talked a lot about Laquan Hilton. But Makuna averaging 13 points a game. He's been quiet so far, but expect him to wake up.
Coming back in, the Giant isn't sleeping anymore. Coming back out to Judge, passing it back out to Bennett, passing it back out to Edible, fighting that clock, 5 seconds left, and they miss on the shot. Going out to Van Hutchinson Jr., unfortunately didn't see McDonald, who was open in the key on time, driving it in and lost the ball. McDonald a bit upset about the fact that nobody saw him open down court in the key, but the ball is going back to Niagara.
Edifil getting a hand in the passing lane there. We talked about his ability to make plays and assist. He's also fifth in the league in steals, so definitely a strong defender as well. Loose ball foul. It's going to go the other way.
Ansel Martin passing this ball into Edifil. Edifil's been taking his time lately, getting it across half court. Rest assured, he's going to drive it as soon as he gets it. Edifil taking it up to the arc, passing it in all the way down to Tyrone Dixon. Where did Tyrone Dixon come from in that one?
He's got 5 points in his opening 2 minutes so far, and I think head coach Patrick Garr is going to realize that he needs to stay in this game. Majulu is a great defender, but he's not as potent offensively as Dixon.
Driving in, we have McDonald trying to get that ball in. Oh, just missing in the key. Passing it out to Edifil for the Hawks, bringing it back up. Edifil standing at half, bringing it in a bit. Guarded by Hilton super tightly. Ansel Martin back outside, right on that arc. Passes out to Bennett. Bennett passes out to Edifil. Edifil tries to pass in to Dixon, but misses. Hilton driving it back up. Just missing on that layup.
McDonald going straight at him. He was out number two. It was 4-on-1.
Amazing. Makuna passing back out to Hutchinson, who passes to McDonald and misses. Edifil bringing it back up the court to Humber. Trying to pass it into Dixon, but I believe it was off the foot of...
And it's good. They're going to rule it. It goes off the foot of Dixon. That's two plays back-to-back now. We've seen entry passes to Dixon go awry.
Hilton bringing it back up. Being guarded tightly here by CJ Bennett. Hilton trying to get it into that key, passing it back out to Makuna. Makuna waking it up, bringing it back for Niagara Knights. Passing into the key. McDonald, 3 seconds on the clock, and misses that shot. Saboni reset on the clock, bringing it back in. And Makuna shooting and misses the three. Bringing it back up, Edifil. Bringing it up to half. Edifil to Judge. Judge trying to drive it in. Passes it out. Ansel Martin passing it into the key.
Oh my goodness. Tyrone Dixon, 7 consecutive points for the Humber Hawks. Ooh, and Edifil trying to be sneaky there.
Edifil getting a bit excited there. We're going to look at a replay of Dixon right here.
Calling for the ball down low. You got to feed the big man when he's rolling. They're doing just that. And a timeout is going to be called by head coach Keith Vassell. A smart move there. 7 consecutive points from Tyrone Dixon. They are really going to need to get a body on him.
Holy, okay. So now it's only a 3-point deficit Where did we start in this half? How many points were we off before? I believe we were off about 13 points going into this half, and now it's a three-point game.
Absolutely. Tyrone Dixon really stepped in, talked about his importance that it would play in the second half, and he's showing just that. He's got the size, and he's got the height. He has the offensive potency to go with it, and he's able to put seven consecutive points up on the board. This is going to play. This is going to be interesting down the line because you can already tell that he's going to be in the game for a lot more than he normally would because of the importance he's playing right now. So if you're the Knights, what do? You get him in foul trouble, you put mileage on his body, and hope that this plays out in the fourth quarter like it did the last time these guys met.
Definitely. I mean, like you said before, top athletes of the OCAA are in this game. So at this point, it's not even a physical game. It's a mental game at this point about overcoming these challenges of just really getting back into the game, focusing themselves, and getting that lead. They're 3 points behind from the Knights, who sit at 46, the Hawks at 43, going back into this. 6 minutes left in the third period. Coming up, trying to pass it into Hilton. Hilton is open, but getting guarded tightly by Bennett. Hilton trying to drive it in, brings it all the way into the key, and oh, beautiful layup.
And that's too easy. That's too easy for Laquan. You got to stop him. Somewhere on the left wing, he just went around defender and defender, and then nobody picked him up until he was well within the key.
Definitely. Ansel Martin taking it out, and oh, beautiful from the top shelf. Just missing that, though. Rebound and taken back by Wilson. Wilson passing it out, bringing it into Makuna. Makuna bringing it back out to Hilton with a pass off there. Just missing on the three, but rebound by Makuna, bringing it back in for the Knights.
And just like that, back-to-back buckets. It's a seven-point lead now.
Edifol bringing it back in, being guarded tightly by Hilton there. Got through with Dixon blocking Cerrone.
So Laquan is going to pick up his second. And that's what you like to see from Edifol, driving the lane. He likes to drive and dish as well, but he's going to go to the line for two.
And just like that, it's a seven-point game.
Absolutely.
I swear I just blinked my eyes. And these boys are keeping it quite a tight match. It's anyone's game, 7 points, 10 points. It doesn't really matter. It can be made up in a matter of seconds.
At a full 78 free throw percent shooter. About four rebounds, five assists a game.
Beautiful from Edible. Full court press coming in from the Hawks here. They're not gonna let Makuna get that ball over court easily. Van Hutchinson Jr. with the ball, driving it into the key. Getting stopped. Judge right on his back there. Niagara's looking for a foul.
Okay, we have two different calls, and it's going to go in favor of the Knights. Official overruling. The Knights will retain it.
Laquan Hilton with the ball. Passing it over to Van Hutchinson Jr. Van Hutchinson passing to Cerrone. Cerrone fumbling a little bit, passing back out to Makuna. Makuna passing into Hilton. Hilton trying to drive that ball back into Wilson in the bottom of the key and missing it. Makuna almost on the rebound and... Oh!
Man advantage.
Van Hutchinson Jr. just missing that there. Oh. Trying to drive it in, get Edifol passing it all the way back up. Holy, what just happened? That was a bit of a blur, these men running. We're gonna have a call here from the ref.
And Edifol talking over with the ref. Full head of steam, and he can't really expect to get that call. He's coming into the defender. Substitutions there, Ajulu, and coming off the bench is going to be Rose.
Coming back in, bring the heat to this game. Six-point game. Hilton passing it back in for the Knights. Looking to pass it in to Makuna, was trying to get open. Came off of his face. Looking at a little bit of an injury here, but I believe he's going to keep playing. Hilton going to pass it in again. We had a pick and roll from Wilson there trying to get open, but unfortunately it did not work on that play. Hilton's going to try for the third time to pass this ball in.
Dixon playing just over half of that quarter. It'll be interesting to see how quickly he's put back into the game.
Hilton trying to pass that ball in a fourth time. See if he can get it. Into Makuna right there in the bottom corner there. Running out, we have Wilson getting open. Hilton back up to the top of the arc, looking for Savoni open, but just gets it, beats the clock.
Making his own shots, making his own plays. Laquan Hilton is in the 20-point ballpark now.
Jordan Rhodes brought it back up, and that's going to be a ball for... the Humber Hawks. 23, Jordan Rose. Passing it back out, coming back out to Judge. Judge passing it out to Rose for three.
More bench points coming in for Humber. That is what they need.
Coming back out to Hilton, getting guarded tightly by Molson. Not going to let him get that ball past that three-point arc. Driving in, but guarded. Molson on the two-man defense. Ajulu cursing there, so close, but it was a push.
It's going to be a loose ball foul, but some great defense there on Laquan Hilton. We saw Molson on him like white on rice, and then Ajulu came to help. It's only the loose ball foul afterwards that drew the second team foul, but that's what they need to do. He has 21 points on the night so far.
Ooh, beautiful attempt to get it in there. Passing to Savoni. Savoni, rather. Coming back out, Mollison been pushing that ball. Guard in his second year from Brampton, Ontario, passing it up to Rose. Rose driving it up to the top of the arc, passing it off nicely to Mollison. Mollison, a little bit of ball work on the double man defense and throwing it back up to Bennett for two and just missing that. Gets rebounded by Wilson of the Knights. Hilton driving it back up, trying to get another point for the Knights there, driving it, but getting completely blocked by Molson there, and then a rebound, which makes a point for the Knights.
Some messy basketball right now. Molson, despite falling over, he still managed to block Laquan, but these loose balls are going in favor of Niagara right now.
Coming out to the Hawks for three, just missing that one for Judge. Look at this, the entire bench is up on the Hawks side.
Judge is still struggling from beyond the arc. He's 0 for 5 from downtown, 0 for 5 from the field.
We're seeing Taylor come in to this game now alongside Morrison.
CJ Bennett.
Good for Bennett. The current score, 48-54. Missing that second one. CJ Bennett trying to drive it in.
And CJ Bennett just taking this himself, drawing foul after foul, going to the line. And he draws another loose ball foul right there, a holding.
Okay, coming back out to Judge. Judge passing it back out to Rose. Travel. Holy, these boys are getting a bit worked up, I believe.
Absolutely. We're just under 3 minutes to go. It's still anybody's ball game. Two possessions. You knock down two threes, and this is a tie game. It's going to come a lot down to this fourth quarter. Who has the heart to take it to the end?
Anybody's game here, Connor. We got Van Hutsinson Jr. driving it forward. Oh, another foul.
Offensive foul.
Charging through, trying to get that ball forward, but unfortunately resulting in a few just messy technical offensive fouls.
The last time the Hawks lost to Niagara in their home gym was in 1983.
Whew.
So a win here for the Knights would be refreshing.
Jordan Rose driving it out, passing it out to Mollison. Mollison out of the arc, getting a pick and block from Ajulu. Looking to get open, doesn't get open on time. Ansel Martin passing it back out to Bennett. Bennett, a little bit of ball work there, passing it back out to Ajulu. 7 seconds on the clock, passes to Ansel Martin, who misses that shot from within the paint. Almost a call there, but they're gonna continue on, moving forward. A bit too much of a pass there from Cooper going out. to DJ Morrison.
And I think this is where the Humber Hawks need to just slow it down. We still have a quarter of basketball to play, and it's only a 6-point deficit that they have to make up. Take your time, get quality shots.
100%. And as we've seen in this game, 6 points is nothing. It can be made up in a matter of moments with athletes of this caliber. Coming back for the Hawks, Jordan Rose passing it in. Rose passes to Ansel Martin at the top, passes to CJ Bennett, passes back to Ansel Martin. 6 seconds left on the clock, passing it in to Jordan Rose, who drives it in, unfortunately misses, but the Knights on the rebound, and Taylor driving it back up. Taylor's a guard in his first year from Toronto, but definitely showing a lot of potential for those Knights.
Absolutely, and just look at this here, Danielle. Coming into this third quarter, the Hawks had 33 points, so half of the points they put up on the board so far have come from Tyrone Dixon, who only played the first half of this quarter.
Wow.
So he is definitely going to have to play some extended minutes in the fourth because the Hawks are struggling offensively without him.
Definitely Rose driving it up. Passes to Julio at the top. Passes into Bennett. Bennett with a little bit of footwork. Passes out to Ansel Martin. Martin passes out to Rose. Rose with the ball. Drives it into the key. Passes it back out. And it goes into Ansel Martin. Shoots and he misses. But all of them are down by that board trying to get that rebound. Jordan McDonald trying to get free down in that key. DJ Morrison with the ball. Drives it in. A little bit of a fumble there off the foot, and it's going back to Humber's ball. I believe we're going to see a full court press right now. Jordan Rose bringing it back up. These boys are hounding them on the defense, not letting them get that ball even past half court. Ansel Martin with the ball now up at that three-point arc. And Bennett was free down there in the corner of the arc there, but I think they're trying to get those points so badly that they're kind of losing focus on who's open and who's free.
Absolutely. We've seen a lot of turnovers from both teams. Humber especially, they have about 15 turnovers, a lot of those coming from risky passes.
Three
into
on the
traffic.
Clock. McDonald passing it all the way up to Van Hutsenson Jr., who drives it in, passes it back out, but intercepted by Mollison, who drives it in, almost gets blocked. The rebound caught by Cooper. DJ Morrison driving it back up for the Knights back at the top of the arc. DJ Morrison taking his time. 5 seconds left on the clock. Oh, a beautiful behind the back pass. Oh, and just misses it. Cooper just throws it away. Holy, Connor. That was almost too quick to call.
Absolutely. I mean, not many stoppages in time. Definitely the refs are letting them play. And a fast-paced game at that, and we can only expect it to pick up. We're now in the fourth quarter. It's crunch time. And the Knights find themselves in a good position. 6 points, they've rested their guys, and they now have control of the pace of the game. Humber, they need to come out, and they're gonna need to get a few big buckets like they did at the beginning of this third.
So the current score, 54 for the Knights and 48 for the Hawks. As we've seen in this game, it's not that hard to get those deficits back and forth, but the Knights have kept ahead in this game. What do you think, Connor, is the key to them keeping that deficit in their favor this game?
Well, you got to give credit to their defense forcing bad shots, but I'm more or less going to look at the horrendous offensive performance from the Humber Hawks. I mean, Ansel Martin is 3-for-11 from the field right now. He's not doing much. Tyrone Dixon is incredibly productive, but he hasn't been able to play too many minutes. Ijulu has attempted one shot this entire game, so he's definitely not as potent offensively as Dixon. Meanwhile, you have guys like Laquan Hilton who are coming down and making individual plays, things that are really opening the floor and increasing this deficit. From downtown, the Humber Hawks, 4-of-15, and that number has only increased. We have updated stats for you now. 6-for-20 from downtown, 18-of-53 from the floor. They're shooting 34% as a unit. And that's not just that's not going to fix anything down the stretch. I think you need to have Dixon play for, if not the whole entire quarter, at least majority of it, because he's the only one who's been getting things done. 13 points, 11 rebounds, a double-double for the big man in his final home game.
Coming up from Taylor, bringing it up for the Knights, looking to pass to DJ. Not going to get it, and intercepted by Edifel. Edifel bringing it back up for the Hawks, getting pressed on that half court. Passing it out. Beautiful little pass. Hand off to Bennett. Bennett trying to hand it off to Ansel Martin. Doesn't work. Driving it back in. And brings it around the world. Ansel Martin.
Ansel Martin, he hasn't had much luck from the field, but in finishing inside the paint, we've seen some flashes. 11 points for him now.
Taylor bringing it up. Stolen by Bennett. Foul coming in.
And here we have a replay coming in, and we see the great pass from Tyrone Dixon and Ansel Martin. 4 of 11 now.
Look for the pass in. Edifel, fifth-year point guard from Brampton, Ontario, going to pass the ball in now, getting blocked closely by Hilton. Passes it off to Ansel Martin, passes it back in to Tyrone Dixon. Dixon almost in the paint there, passes it back out to Ansel Martin, out to Bennett for three. No, he dekes him and he drives into the paint for two.
And that's where Bennett is so lethal on the baseline, driving and making his own buckets.
Definitely. We got the All-Stars back on the court right now. Hopefully they can make up that deficit. It's anyone's game now, 52 to 54 for the Knights. DJ Morrison at the top of the key, passing it out. Makuna passing it back out to McDonald, driving it in for two. Hawks ball bringing it back up, gives another full.
We can expect to see some high screener rolls with Tyrone Dixon right here looking for the opening, but they can't find him.
And so Martin back up at the top, Edifel back at top, 8 seconds left on the clock. Edifel needs to drive this one in, brings it out. Oh, just missed there, Dixon. Just from underneath that backboard. Struggling to get that ball back up again. And missing one more time from Dixon. Hilton grabbing that ball, wasting no time, getting back down that court. Hilton drives it in. Comes back out to the arc, resets. Passes it in to McDonald. McDonald struggling to get that ball up. 4 seconds on the clock, and it's in.
Few offensive possessions that go in favor of Niagara. 6 points now.
Still, anyone's game. Edifel brings it back up. Lots of movement in the key. Edifel looking to pass out to Bennett. And that was a traveling violation from Bennett.
And that one was close. We've seen a few blatant travels so far, but that one was tight, and CJ Bennett not happy, but I'm still definitely impressed with his play. He's been making shots for his teammates.
It was a bit close to call, so we're going to look at that again.
And that's what he loves, going down the baseline, beats his defender, and goes up from under the rim.
DJ Morrison bringing it back up for the Niagara Knights. Getting guarded closely by Bennett. Going to have to watch those hands there. Driving it back in for the Knights. Getting stolen, being brought back up and shot by Makuna. Him and Saboni both falling on the ground after that, but it is going to be a Hawks ball after this substitution. Mollison returning to the game.
Absolutely. And Ansel Martin's got 11 points right now. He's had a solid performance so far, struggling from the field. I personally like Molson as a defender. We might see him on Laquan trying to shut down the point guard, who still has 21.
Edifel to Dixon, back out to Molson. Molson passing back out to Bennett. Bennett to Molson. Oh, deking out for the shot and back to Bennett. Oh, for three, but he just misses off the rim. Going back in to Hilton.
Bennett's one of five from downtown.
Ooh. That was a block from Molson trying to show them that he's in the hawk's nest right now.
Absolutely. Molson, he's had a rough shooting performance so far. He's 0 for 4 from the field, and he's 0 for 3 from downtown, but he's a great defender, and they're definitely going to have him sticking Laquan.
Back up to the top of the key. Molson passing back out for 3 from Makuna. Just misses. Edipal wasting no time getting back down that court. Passing out to Molson. Molson for 3 and just misses off that at that rim again. Passing it out to Cascart. Passing it back out to Edipal. Edipal driving in and shooting but missing. But a rebound coming from the Hawks. From Bennett.
And that is going to go against the 4 blue. Savoni going to pick a foul upon re-entry. And there's CJ Bennett again showing a lot of heart going up there with Dixon to get those rebounds. And he'll go to the line for 2, a 77% free throw shooter. CJ Bennett has been having himself a night.
He definitely has. Him and Edipal haven't had too much of a break here, playing a lot on this court. Who do you think we need to bring in? Do you think this lineup is going to get us to the top?
In the fourth quarter, you got to go with who has been showing you that they can play in this third. And I like Molson as defender and Edipal, the fifth year in his final home game. The veteran, you have to keep him in there. One person you don't touch is Tyrone Dixon. That is for sure.
Yeah. He can't get too comfortable on the bench ever. And that was a beautiful 3 for Makuna coming from the Knights. It is now 54-61 for the Knights. Edipal bringing it back up. Driving it in. He's not wasting any time. Edipal for 2. Hilton driving it back up.
Molson getting a hand in there, diving, and that's what you like to see off the foot of Laquan. Molson getting a stop.
Hilton and Edipal, as 2-point guards, are not wasting any time this game. They're just bringing it back and back and back and forth. So quick this game. Who do you think is faster?
I don't know. They're both pretty athletic guys.
Going forward, coming to Molson. Molson passing out to Dixon. Dixon passing out to Bennett. Bennett driving it in almost for 2. Dixon trying to get that rebound. Goes back to the Knights. Knights coming back up. And Hutchinson Jr. trying to drive it in. Bennett quick on the defense.
And this is where you got to turn on the Jets. They got a man advantage. Edipal sees it. He goes all the way.
Edipal. Oh, Dixon. Bennett takes a moment to try and calculate that, but unfortunately misses. Going back in to Wilson, and then to Hutchinson, who makes that shot. Score is now 56-63.
13 points for Hutchinson. We hadn't seen much of him in the third, but now with a 7-point lead, and we are past the halfway mark. Humber has got to capitalize on these threes and these shots in the paint. They just have to make them.
Okay, Bennett bringing it in.
Another one against Savoni. He's going to take the loose ball foul, push from behind, and Savoni. Bennett's going to take a break.
Savoni arguing that and being put back onto the bench. He is one of their key players, so taking him off is a big and risky move at this point in the game. Edipal passing back into Dixon. Dixon passing back out to Judge. Judge passing it into Edipal. Back out to Molson. Molson driving it in. And that's going to be a foul.
It's going to be an offensive foul going against Molson. And he has still yet to put up a bucket on the board. Trayvon Molson, phenomenal defensively, but struggling offensively. And Ansel Martin now, he's 5 of 12. They need him now more than ever.
Knights are being completely pressed, trying to get it across half. Only 4 minutes left in the game. The Hawks are fighting for this one. Being defended by Molson, driving it in. We have McDonald down from the paint. Fortunately, misses it. So, going back to the Hawks, Molson just hustling to get that ball back.
Oh,
foul on Hilton.
Quan Hilton now with three personals. But since we are in the fourth, not too much of a worry there.
Edipal bringing it back up against Hilton. Back up to Ansel Martin at the top. Looking to get Tyrone Dixon open. He's not open, so he's looking. He's staying around that arc, and he passes, and he shoots for three. Edipal misses that. Hustling back up, and Hutchinson Jr. for the Niagara Knights. Trying to get someone who's open. Refocusing for a second, but drives back in and assists that ball to McDonald. Beautiful pass.
And back-to-back plays and some poor offensive play from the Humber Hawks in these closing minutes has resulted in a 9-point lead. We had this same problem the last time these two teams met. Humber only put up 8 points in the fourth quarter, and they're averaging even less than that now. Meanwhile, the Knights taking their time, getting easy lay-in buckets. Patrick Aw, head coach, timeout. And we'll see what he draws up. Meanwhile, the Knights sitting very comfortably with that 9-point lead. They just got to hold on to the ball now and play their game.
Definitely we're seeing a few little fouls coming in, offensive and defensive. Do you think that these boys are just having trouble staying in the game, getting a bit more aggressive, or do you think it's purposeful?
Definitely think it has something to do with both teams in blue between the other. So some great defense from the Niagara Knights. We can't take anything away from that. They have the Humber Hawks shooting below 30%, which is something they haven't done all year long. And they know what's riding on this game. There is a bye at risk here. The loser will have to play a crossover game. And this could potentially affect one's OCAA standing. Remember, Sheridan, the number one team in their country, also happens to be in their division, and don't count on them losing anytime soon.
And we're back at it with Judge passing the ball in for the Hawks to Edipal, getting two men on him. Edipal having trouble just getting it across half court. Back to Judge. Judge passes out to Edipal. Edipal at the arc. Looking around, passes out to Ansel Martin. Ansel Martin drives it in and gets intercepted by McDonald. McDonald driving it back in, tries to pass it to Hilton. Intercepted by Martin. Martin driving it back up for the Hawks.
Oh, an offensive foul. Everything going against the Hawks right now.
You know, when we talk about those strategic fouls, we have seen Van Hutchinson Jr. really plant and make sure he's getting a few offensive fouls on the Humber Hawks.
Absolutely. And it's silly mistakes like that that the Humber Hawks are committing. Turnovers late in the game that you just can't do. Fourth quarter turnovers are the Achilles heel of every basketball team ever.
Okay, we're going. McDonald trying to get it in, passing it back into Van Hutchinson. And back to the Hawks.
And it is now a double-digit lead, the largest of the game, coming in the final 2 minutes and 30 seconds.
We have that going out to Ansel Martin. Ansel Martin passing out to Molson. Molson passing out to Dixon. Dixon passing out to CJ Bennett. Bennett drives it in, goes in, and gets absolutely blocked by Van Hutchinson Jr. And Hutchinson Jr. standing at 6'4", makes it look easy to block that.
Having him inside, we talked about this, the fact that he plays so many minutes just because he can do it on both ends of the floor.
Definitely, I don't think he's had much time to rest this game.
No, he doesn't. He doesn't want to. He wants to be out there, and Ansel Martin's going to draw that for two, stopping the clock just at the two-minute mark. He can make this a single-digit lead.
And this is what has made this game so interesting, is that both teams want it so badly. Like you said, he doesn't want to be on the bench because he wants to win this game so badly. It's a huge game for both teams. Ansel Martin on his second shot, 57-67 for the Knights. And he makes it. Now 9 points again to the single digits. Stolen by Van Hutchinson Jr. Drives it up that court for a beautiful, easy layup.
And Hutchinson Jr., 33 minutes on the night, and he is not tired at all. He's just going right down coast to coast.
Driving, Edipal attempts, misses that easy layup. Coming back down the court, we have Wilson bringing it in. passing it out to Hilton. Hilton taking a moment. Looking
just
around.
Winding down the clock, 24 yep. seconds at a time.
DJ Morrison's open, but he's just going to use that shot clock, milk it for all it's worth, drives it in, and gets that easy shot. The Knights really pulling through right now.
13 points.
Back out to Martin. Martin trying to drive it in.
Tyrone Dixon with the bucket. And that is actually his first bucket this fourth quarter.
Wow.
That is his first bucket this fourth quarter. He's been out there. He has been active, but they have not gotten him involved offensively. But Dixon going to the line for what will be his second three-point play of the night. And a nice drop-off there from Ansel Martin.
Dixon on the line. And he makes that shot. Coming back, we have the Knights driving forward. Van Hutsen Jr. wants this so badly. Passes out to McDonald, but gets stolen. Brought all the way back up by Edipal. Missing those layups down in the paint. Misses again off the rebound and stolen. But back to Martin. Martin shoots and he scores from the top of the key.
This quick steal from Edipal off his two missed layups, and now it's single digits. It's 8 points. TJ out on the races.
Oh, makes an easy rebound off his own layup. Able to bring it back in, refocus this team. That's going to be a foul on Edipal. Lots of fouls coming out in this last period. You know how badly they want it when there's just foul, foul, foul.
Absolutely. The Hawks have some fouls to give. They're going to look to stop play at the very least. Or get a quick steal. And just some confusion with the officials. And they are good to go.
Van Hutsen Jr. passing it in. Wilson drives it in, misses. Ansel Martin wants that ball bad. But back in to Van Hutsen Jr. That's a beautiful play. He wants this game so bad.
Bumping into his own teammate, he still gets up. He's got 19 points on the night. Laquan with 23.
Edipal to Martin. Martin back to Edipal. Edipal at the top of the arc. Gonna have to slow it down. Back to Bennett. Back to Mollison. Mollison back to Bennett for three, and he misses. And Dixon did not get that rebound.
And they're going to look to stop time, but they are close to the bonus. Be the fourth team foul. They will inbound at half.
Unfortunately, I don't think these seniors are getting the final home game that they may have wanted. But you know what? They've worked very hard for it, and they should be very proud of themselves. Win or lose, they worked their butts off this game.
Absolutely, and there's still more games to come. They have a few away games and, of course, the OCAAs and the CCAAs if they do qualify. And this Humber team plans on doing so. As you mentioned, not quite the send-off from home that they wanted, but they know that this is just the beginning.
Fingers crossed for the OCAAs. And Hilton on the line for one. Now back to 11
points. Does it again, 22, and the nail in the coffin in their first meeting way back when. And 26 points on the night. Timeout called.
Timeout. Yeah, we have people leaving the gymnasium right now. People are calling this game. I believe it's safe to say that the Knights have taken this game. What is your opinion, Connor? What do you think it was? What was the key to them taking this game?
Well, I said this after the third, and I'm going to say it again. Not to be redundant, you got to give a lot of credit to the Niagara defense, but I really just blame this on the poor shooting from the Humber Hawks. You know, you got Balzi Judge. He didn't make a bucket tonight. He went 0 from the field. You got Trayvon Mollison. He didn't make a bucket from the field. You have Ajulu. He only put up one shot. Didn't make it. Tyrone Dixon was the only one that was really active offensively on a consistent basis. And in the fourth quarter, he barely put up any shots up until the later stages. So I just look at that as well as the fact that Niagara, a team that traditionally doesn't shoot the three ball that often, just went off, or I should call Niagara, a.k.a. Laquan Hilton, who went off from downtown and put up a lot of shots. Ansel Martin, he had a rough night from the field besides some points inside the paint, and you just got to be more consistent offensively when you're going up against the second-best offense in the OCAA, number one, only behind Sheridan, number one in the country.
Definitely, and we got to say, Niagara has not given up on keeping their star players, no matter how much of a deficit there is, keeping them on the court at all times.
Absolutely. Hutchison's amazing conditioning, and it's little shots like that in and around the rim that Edifel, that Ansel Martin have not been able to put away, and I just think that that's part of the night, that's part of the game, that's part of the team that you're playing.
We've seen Edifel with a few just easy layups and even catching his own rebound and missing it. You know, it's easy to see that he's gotten his head a little bit too much in this game and not able to refocus.
The Humber Hawks will take their third loss this season, coming to Niagara twice and Sheridan once. The top two teams in their division.
We've got McDonald on the line, shooting for two. He misses that basket.
Yep.
Tyrone Dixon right there under the net looking for that rebound. But it's going to go back to the Niagara Knights, coming back to Van Hutsison Jr. Throws it
up. Oh, going for the lob there. And they are just trying to wind out the clock. They know this game is all but wrapped up.
Oh, yeah. Cooper just flew for that one, just looking to waste a little bit of time on this clock. I mean, at this point, I think we're just trying to play the best game we can and lose with as much grace as possible. Because you know what? They did work as hard as they could. And I think Niagara kept quite a bit of a small lead. But the entire game, unfortunately for the Hawks, they were never quite able to recover.
Absolutely, they were not. Niagara led all this game. The Hawks were there, but they couldn't quite take the lead. And Niagara finally, with that third quarter, put them away. Specifically the second quarter, though, where Niagara outscored the Hawks 27-19. And they have not been able to make up that deficit. Although it was 8 points, it set a precedent for the quarters to come.
Definitely. We're coming back in. 14 seconds left. You know what? I think that these boys should be very proud of what they put on the court today, what they've put into these past few seasons. And you know what they gave last season? The fact that they were able to make it back to the CCAAs after a 14-year-old dry spell is something to be proud of.
Absolutely. And this isn't the end. They still have four games to go. They start a four-game win. A four-game road trip on the 28th of this month against Mohawk. Then they go and play the number one team in the country, Sheridan, February 4th.
Hopefully a four-game win.
More. Absolutely, and that's going to sound it.
That's it. Definitely not the end for these Humber Hawks. And we had a great game from the women earlier this morning. CJ Nufuente breaking a record.
Absolutely, becoming the all-time leading scorer in women's basketball. And 63-75 is the final score. 12-point deficit definitely doesn't tell the story of the whole game, though. Humber with them every step of the way up until that fourth quarter, where once again the Knights winning the marathon, not the sprint.
Definitely. It was a close game the entire time, and points were just gained back and forth just like that. A lot of turnovers, a lot of rebounds, a lot of steals, and a lot of fouls coming in that final period.
Absolutely, trying to draw out the time, but again, a very poor shooting performance from Humber. Season lows, 34% from the field, 18 of 53, and we have final numbers right here. In terms of rebounds, you look 51 for the Knights, 44 for Humber, but when you look at things like turnovers, 19 to 17, and field goal percentage, 32%, the Humber Hawks were 23 from 71, and they were 26% from beyond the arc. That is killer when you're going up against a team that can score like the Knights do. So all in all, a good game, and I think Humber has a lot to look forward to with the coming four games.
Definitely. And now we're going to look to Danielle on the sideline for some further information and hopefully an athlete interview after this game.
So we're here at the sideline, and unfortunately the boys did not get what they wanted to get. But the thing is, they still should be so proud of what they've been doing this season. We still have four more games on the road, and things could be looking up for them. They played hard today, and you can tell that they were thirsty for that win. But you know what? They just got to keep their heads up high. and we're going to throw it back to the commentators. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Danielle. Couldn't have said it better myself. These boys do have something to be proud of tonight. I'm Danielle D'Entremont.
Connor Forrest.
And thank you so much for hanging out with us tonight in the Hawk's Nest.